those figures for the, their calculation. Did you agree with how they calculated, or was there a difference?
No, there wasn't a difference. It's external factors influencing company development. There was a scale used of 1 to 5, and the explanation of what the 1 to 5 meant wasn't clear. The academic concern has now said to us that the horizontal axis scored from 1 to 5 is the strength of the factor identified by companies participating in one survey. So 5 is a very strong factor, 1 is marginal. That was not clear in the first class. That's, and his name is Dr. Frakishkos Philippios, leader in international business at Kent Business School.
Hello,
Kruger.
Three generations.
Excuse me, are there any aids to the
Spitfire
meeting? Or is it something
separate? That will be in the master plan. When we publish the master plan, we will be showing a larger site for the Spitfire Museum and also some visualisations of what we think it could look like. We've had some discussions with the Spitfire Museum. They've been in a difficult position, really, because they've got funds that are available to them, but they don't know what they can spend it on. We've said that we could fund part of it, working with them, and we're keen to see it work. You know. So we're thinking of the area where they are now, through to the old control tower, which I think I've said this before, we originally thought maybe they'd want that, and they all said it's a piece of rubbish, we don't want it, it's not authentic and it's terrible, it needs to go. Fine, you know, we're not going to argue with that. So we would say to them, you can have that entire site and probably then be able to move your parking further away from where it is now, making the whole thing more accessible. We'll be publishing some visualizations next week, and the visualization, it's a bit more than just a dream, it's actually, you know, had some work put into it of what the museum might look like, will be in there. But yeah, we're very keen to see it continue.
Is that the same with the Manchester Museum as well?
With the Engineering Museum?
Yeah.
We want that to keep, we want that to stay. As to where that should be, that's a different story, because that's more of an engineering museum, but that should certainly be somewhere on the site, yes.
Craig, would you like to say some words?
I will, if I may. Thank you very much, Joe. I think we've got enough table there. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I know Tony mentioned the general election as something that probably Roger and I knew about. Well, we didn't, actually. My wife told me. She was watching the television. And I said, did you know there's going to be an election on the 8th of June? And I said, well, thanks very much. But that was really, I think, one of the best kept secrets I think I've ever come across. The other, I'm afraid, too much of a secret, is the value to this country of what Menston could be. And I know Roger has been a champion of Manston for longer than I have, because I've only been, was your MP until dissolution for just 2 years. But we've, between us, been champions of what Manston could mean for the regional economy, particularly the economy of East Kent. And whenever there's the opportunity in either Westminster Hall debates or on the floor of the House, we always extol the virtues of what we have here and what it could possibly be. Very sad to hear that 3 years since the last KLM flight. I can't believe that. It seems to have gone so very quickly. And I'm sure that all of you in the room share my frustration at the stupidity of the current owners. But why don't they just give in, sell up, and let's get on with this project.
The question is,
Roger,
the reason I want Manston to succeed, not least I have some awareness and background in the aviation industry.
I'm altruistic. I'm selfish. Because I want Thanet to have one of the most thriving economies in the whole of Kent and the South East. We've heard that we are behind on many measures of wealth and health and education and ambition. And I hear that regularly across Thanet. I don't want it to be like that. Because I believe that Manston could be the real kickstart of some great jobs for this area. Not just warehousing jobs at minimum wage. Not just another load of housing, build them higher and sell them
at high value as well, which are the current plans for the Stonehill Park. Because Manson has got a huge regional and national future, but that's why we're here, to keep supporting that. And the number of jobs, 10,000 jobs, these would be good jobs. These would be the jobs that our children will be able to look up to, that colleges would be able to provide courses for. This would be the kickstart of this part of Kent. But I don't need to tell you all that, because this is what we've been fighting for together for a long time. Now, there's been lots of, wonderful ideas come forward from different quarters. And throughout these last 2 and 3 years, both Roger and myself have been pursuing anybody who's shown an interest in Manson Airport, and we've pursued them as hard as we possibly could. But I'm very pleased to say there's been just one company that has kept the faith throughout this, with significant spending in everything they do. We've already heard $2.5 million committed so far, and probably another $2.5 million to see this DCO project through. They're not flying kites. They're serious, and they're serious because they want this airport to work, not just obviously for in pursuit of profit, which is a great thing, but it's in pursuit of a future for a national asset that will also be good for this area. And what is so exciting? And what is so exciting, this isn't just some scruffy project with a new lick of paint to make a fairly down at heel airport something a little more than it currently is. This is a whole new plan to create a regional base for cargo, and then hopefully after that, as it establishes itself as a passenger base, that's actually ready for the 21st century. So I'm excited. I've been through some ups and downs on this whole saga for the last few years, and I think this time last year I was a little bit downcast. But now I'm more excited than ever that this will happen. So I'm with you all the way, and I'd like to thank River Oak for keeping the faith with us as well. Thank you.